if they even quit.
Hey, Matt, it's Ted and Gary.
Put us up in queue and we'll holler at you.
All right. Give me a chance. Hold on a minute.
Okay.
51-31.
I can hear you.
I could hear you then.
Testing, 1-2, test. Hey, Matt, start the intro in 1 minute, please, 1 minute.
Coffeyville, Panther basketball is on the air. Financial. The star of the game brought to you by Greyheart Feed. The Coach's Corner brought to you by Stoppler Truck.
These are guys from the Carlisle tournament.
The pregame show brought to you by Moore Brothers Auto Sales, where you always get more for less. And now, Ted Cunningham and Gary Pratt.
Good evening, basketball fans, and welcome to Thomas Gym for tonight's conference matchup between cross-county rival the DuQuoin Indians and the Panthers of Pinckneyville. I'm Ted Cunningham, and Gary Pratt's alongside. And, Gary, the Panthers need to get back on a winning note here.
Yeah, they do, and make a nice run here to close out the regular season, head into postseason. Big conference game. Got to keep winning those conference games.
Indeed we do. Right now, let's take a one-minute timeout. We'll be back with Gary on our Moore Brothers pregame show. You're listening to Panther Basketball on WXAN and PCSportsInfo.net.
At Moore Brothers Auto Sales on Illinois Highway 154 in Pinckneyville, they are the small town dealer with the big time savings. At Moore Brothers Auto Sales, their customers know they can count on quality used cars, great prices, and a knowledgeable sales staff. Whether you're looking for an automobile, a truck, a van, or an SUV, you can find what you need at Moore Brothers Auto Sales. You can call them or text them anytime at 357-2711. And shop online through their website at moorebrothersautosales.com.
All right, back here at Thomas Gymnasium, we welcome you to our Moore Brothers Auto Sales pregame show. Tonight, the Panthers and the DuQuoin Indians get set to go at it. Game three of a triple header here at Thomas Gymnasium tonight. The Panthers won the freshman game by a score of 41-26. Panther JV team won the second game by a score of 51-31. They improved to 14-2 on the season. So it's time for game number three, the varsity game. So let's take a quick look at the DuQuoin Indians. They are coached by Webster McGuire. The JV coach is Joshua Coloni. Assistant coach is Tyler Crone. And another assistant coach is Jim Hammers. The Indians are 7-15 on the season. They are 1-5 in conference play. Their lone conference win came back on December the 19th. They defeated West Frankfort over at West Frankfort High School by a score of 48-36. So the Indians 7-15, 1-5 on the season. The Panthers are 19-7 on the season, and they are 4-2 in conference play, coached by Matt Lars in his first season as the head coach of the Panthers, assisted by Hunter Queen, Lane Woodside, Richie Williams, and C.J. Opp. Panthers coming off of a interconference game Tuesday night over in Heron. Panthers dropped that game to the Tigers. I think that final was by about 15 points to fall to 19-7 on the season. So Matt Lahr tries for the second time here in this basketball season to take on the DuQuoin Indians here at Thomas Gymnasium. These two teams met at Andrews Gym over in DuQuoin on Friday, December the 15th. The Panthers won that one by a score of 54-43 behind Hunter Smith's 12 points, 15 points from A.J. Keith, and 11 from Carson Conkle. The Indians faced by Traylon Smith, who had 16, and Dwayne Wilmington, who had 11 points in that contest. That game was tied 12-12 at the quarter break, 26-26 at the half. Panthers up 6, 38-32 at the end of 3, and they won it 54-43. So a very tightly played ball game for almost three-quarters of that game over there at DuCoin, where the Panthers pulled it out there in the fourth quarter. So we have a packed crowd here at Thomas Gymnasium, and we've had some dancing girls out here in between the ball games at the halftime, I think, of one of the games, and they just introduced the basketball teams from the feeder schools here at the Pinckneyville High School. So we have all that out of the way, and we're ready for varsity basketball. The Panthers with a couple of injured players, in fact, three of them now in street clothes. I saw Wyatt Bird in street clothes, and Mr. Crabtree is in street clothes, and Lucas Leitz was injured in that JV ball game. He's on crutches over sitting there behind the bench, so we'll have to see. Panthers a little short on guards in this game. We'll see how that affects things. So that's our Moore Brothers Auto Sales pregame show here for this evening. We want to thank you for joining us. Stay tuned for the broadcast and all the play-by-play action. Panther basketball is next right here on WXAN and PC Sports Info as we stream this live to YouTube. We're going to take a two-minute timeout. We'll be back after this.
At Moore Brothers Auto Sales on Illinois Highway 154 in Pinckneyville, they are the small town dealer with the big time savings. At Moore Brothers Auto Sales, their customers know they can count on quality used cars, great prices, and a knowledgeable sales staff. Whether you're looking for an automobile, a truck, a van, or an SUV, you can find what you need at Moore Brothers Auto Sales. You can call them or text them anytime at 357-2711. Shop online through their website at morebrothersautosales.com.
Trading Station has the largest gun selection in Southern Illinois. The Hicks family has been located at 4952 State Route 13 in Pinckneyville for over 63 years. Hicks Trading Station has over 2,000 new and used guns in stock. A wide selection of ammunition is also available. They will buy, sell, or trade. And get this, everything is guaranteed. They're open 7 days a week from 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. 357-2583. Go Panthers!
Greatheart products are second to none when it comes to seed quality, seed treatment, and seed performance. Farmers continuously brag about the appearance of our seed as it comes out of the bag, the vigor in which it comes out of the ground, and the high yields coming out of their fields year in and year out. I would describe Greatheart products with two words, quality and performance.
All right, back here at Thomas Gymnasium, we are getting set for basketball action here tonight. The Panthers and the DuCoin Indians, and you know, when these two teams get together, anything can happen. So let's take a look at the projected starting lineups in this ball game. And Indians expected to start Eli Maynor, number 5, a 6-foot senior. Tyon Bardo Spiller, a 6'4 senior. He'll wear number 10. Number 14, Drake Jewell, a 6'1 senior. Number 15, Traylon Smith, a 5'8 senior. And number 1, Jaden Davis, 5'9 junior. Maynard's a 6-foot senior. Bardo Spiller is a 6'4 senior. Jewel a 6'1 senior. Traylon Smith, a 5'8 senior. Jaden Davis, is a 5'9 junior. Panthers will go with Brady Conway, number 10. He's a 5'9 junior. Well, we're going to have the national anthem first. Our national anthem by the Pinckneyville Pep Band. Panther lineup is Brady Conway. He's a 5'9 junior, wears number 10. Number 20 is Hunter Smith. He's a 6-foot senior. Number 30, Riley Bowersack, a 6'5 junior. A.J. Keith, number 32, he's a 6'4 junior. And Carson Conkle, number 45, a 6'6 senior. So we'll double check the lineups here as they're introduced. The Indians wear the black uniforms with the red and white trim. They got the white numbers on their uniforms. Number 15 was Traylon Smith. 21 is Demarion Johnson. Here's Eli Maynor. Wayne Wilmington starting here tonight, so a different lineup. Mr. Jewell, Drake Jewell. So no Bardo Spiller. No Jaden Davis. It's Maynor, Jewell, Smith, Wilmington, and Johnson for the Indians. So the Panthers have been introduced. Panther cheerleaders up at state competition, right?
Yeah, and they finished in the top 10 today, so they advance to the finals tomorrow.
So this is
want to wish them well.
That's right. This is a 204 Tiger cheerleaders, right?
No, I think it's a junior high.
Junior high cheerleaders, okay. All right, and these officials we had up at the Carlisle tournament, one of them is named Becker.
Becker.
But they're a veteran officiating crew. So we are set to go. Hope you'll enjoy our broadcast. And here to tell you about this one, here's Ted Cunningham.
Thank you, Gary. Into the midcourt tip circle, Greg Jewell and Carson Conkle, the official, stepping in with the basketball. And we are underway. Keith with the ball in the backcourt. He'll bring it into the front half for the Panthers. Keith will give it up to Conway. Over to the left it goes now to Hunter Smith. Back out on top to Keith. Right side to Barsatz. Down the corner, Smith. Now Barsatz at the right wing. Smith deep in the right corner. 2-3 zone applied by the Indians here in the opening quarter. With the ball, Conway now. Conway picks it up. He'll give it over to Keith. Keith down in the corner to Hunter Smith for three. Good. And that's the way the ball game starts. With the ball is Demarion Johnson. Johnson in the front court. He'll give it left to Eli Maynard. Maynard with the ball. Now out on top to Wilmington. Picked off by Conway. As it, that was intended for Jewell. I believe I said Wilmington. With the ball deep in the left corner. His ball is sacked. And the Panthers open with back-to-back threes. It'll be a 30-second timeout. Charging the Indians. We'll take it as well. You're listening to Panther Basketball on WXAN. Inbound play will be created by Jewell. He'll get it into Demarion Johnson. Johnson into the front court. Now kicks it out in the left corner. Gives the ball back to Jewell. On top it goes now to Traylon Smith. The short and the rebound comes to Conway. Conway ahead to Barsatz. Barsatz open for another three. And it hit the guy wire as it bounded off the goal. Inbound play comes to Traylon Smith. Now back to Jewell, ahead to Johnson. Now the ball to Eli Maynard. Maynard with the ball. Ball tipped away and recovered by Hunter Smith. Down the lane to Conway. Up and in. And it's an 8-0 Panther lead. With the ball is Smith now for the Indians. Smith picked up by Keith. Stops short of the timeline. Goes ahead now to Jewell. Over to the left side to Johnson. His shot rejected by Carson Conkle. Inbound play will be created by Jewell. He'll set up left of the goal. Gets the ball into Maynard. Maynard's shot is good. He hit a three off the pick and the curl, and it's an 8-3 game. Back comes Conway now for the Panthers. Crosses into the front half. He'll give it up to Keith. Keith with the ball now. Smith. Smith. Out on top to Keith. Keith for three. That's no good. Rebound. Got a foul on the Panthers on the rebound. They call this on Conway, it looks like. 8-3 Panthers and 5:49 left in the opening quarter. Inbound play comes to Smith. Smith into the front court on the left. He'll give that up to Maynard. Maynard cuts to the lane, stops, couldn't get the shot off, needs help, and gives it over to Smith now. Smith with the ball between the circles, over to the left. That was Johnson. Now Smith. Smith into the lane, puts up a shot and hits. And it's an 8-5 game. Back come the Panthers. Conway inside to Conkle. Conkle works into the goal, puts it up and in. It's a 10-5 game. With the ball, Jewell, now Johnson. Johnson with the ball in the backcourt. Johnson over to the left, it goes to Smith. Smith high on the left side. Down the corner to Johnson. Johnson with the dribble. Now to Jewell. Jewell tries to back Conkle down. Nothing doing there. Out on top it goes to Smith. Now Maynard. Maynard right of the lane. Stopped. His shot's partially blocked by Hunter Smith, and back come the Panthers. Conway into the front court. He'll give it out to Barsax. Barsax has picked it up after the dribble. Gives it inside to Conkle. Conkle at the free throw line. Down left of the goal. And he's called for traveling. The inbound play will occur right below us. Jewell will trigger the inbound play. Gets it into Smith. Smith with the ball. Smith over on the left side to Johnson. Johnson at the left wing now reverses. Kicks it across to the right side to Wilmington. Now to Maynard down the lane. And a blocking foul called on Conway.
Well, 10 on a night when we're short guards. Conway's picked up two fouls early.
Two quick ones. It's going to bring Ty Lahr off the bench, and Conway's going to go out. Maynard has shoot a pair of free throws. And the score 10-5 with 4:15 left here in the opening quarter. Maynard's free throw shot came up short. He'll shoot the second of the two-shot foul. Maynard takes his time, and now he's ready to go. This one's in the air and in the hook. It's a 10-6 game, and the Panthers with the basketball. Keith has it into the front court. Keith moves to the right, gives it to Hunter Smith. Smith, now Lahr at the top of the circle. Lahr goes back to the left of Barsax at the wing. Out on top to Keith now. Keith with the ball, now Smith. Smith, now Lahr. Lahr right of the circle. Goes inside to Keith. Partially blocked and recovered by the Indians. Over to the right, it goes to Johnson. Johnson down the corner to Wilmington. Wilmington for three, shoots an air ball. And the Panthers get it back. Smith with the ball, now Keith. Keith is fouling the play as he goes to the basket. And the foul is Eli Maynard picks up the foul. Inbound play will be triggered by Ty Lahr. He'll set up left of the goal. Maynard gets the ball into Hunter Smith. Smith's shot is short. The rebound comes to Conkle. Conkle in heavy traffic. Up and a counter. And he'll go to the line with a chance to complete a three-point play. That makes it 12-6 with Conkle at the free throw line. Free throws up and short. The rebound to Johnson. Johnson into the front court. Now between the circles, right to Smith. Traylon Smith. Lost the dribble, now regains it. Still working on the right side. Works through traffic. Walked with the basketball. Colton Smith comes in. For Barsax, 12-6 Panthers, and 3:05 left in the opening quarter of play. Hunter Smith into the front court now. Works over to the right, gives it to Lahr. Lahr down. Now we got a foul on Wilmington as he was holding Conkle. And he's picked up two fouls. Ty Lombardo comes in. Lahr gets it, play into Keith, up and in. Back comes Smith now, Traylon Smith. Over to the left, he'll give it up to Bardo. Now Bardo at the top. Now the right, it goes to Maynard. Now the ball to Jewell. Deep on the left side to Smith. Out on top to Bardo. Right side to Johnson. Johnson with the ball. He'll give it up to Jewell. Jewell, now Maynard. Now the ball to Bardo. Out to the left it goes to Maynard. Now the ball to Johnson. They go inside to Jewell. Jewell, the ball pops loose, but Johnson's able to run it down in the corner. Johnson with the basketball out near midcourt. 2:10 left in the first period. With the ball at the right is Smith. Out on top it goes to Jewell. His pass is intercepted by Keith, and Keith lays it in. And it's 16-6. Back comes Johnson now. Johnson between the circles. Over to the right to Smith. Smith with the ball. Cuts in under the basket. His shot's up. No good. Rebound to Colton Smith. And the outlet goes to Hunt, to Keith. Keith across the timeline. Over to the right side it goes to Colton Smith. Out on top to Lahr. Lahr with the ball now. Keith. Oh. And
Keith got hammered and no call.
Yeah. Out of bounds off of DuCoin, but Keith really got hammered there. Barsax comes back in the game. The Indians countered with a couple of substitutions. Jonathan Brown is one of those. Lahr gets the ball into Barsax. Barsax up, no good. Rebound control by Brown. He'll give it back to Johnson. Johnson in the front court. Now left side to Brown. Intercepted by Smith. Smith's going to take it all away and miss. Rebound comes out and recovered by Colton Smith. He slipped and fell. Now the ball goes the other way. Shot is up. And a goaltending call on the Panthers. Jeremiah Jones after the Panther turnover.
Give Jones the basket, you say?
Yes. Into the game comes A.J. Keith. It's 16-8 now. 16-9 or 8, Gary?
16-8.
Inbound play comes to Colton Smith into the front court. He'll give it to Ty Lahr. And Lahr.
Well, Keith tripped and almost fell.
And he couldn't recover, could he?
No.
16-8 to score. Under a minute to play here in the quarter now. Johnson will bring it into the front court. Johnson works to the top of the key. Goes left side to Maynard now. Maynard down in the left corner. Maynard gives the ball up to Brown. Brown. Cross court now. The ball goes to Jones. Now back to Johnson. Johnson at the right wing. Kicks it out to... And the three is missed by Jones. And back come the Panthers. Down to the final 15 seconds of the quarter. Keith at the top. Picked up by Johnson. Works over to the right. Kicks it in the corner to Colton Smith. Now to Lahr. Down to the final 4 seconds. Barsax has got to shoot in a hurry. And they came up short. We played a quarter. It's 16-8 Pinckneyville. We'll be back in 1 minute.
Life is made up of moments. We care about those moments as much as you do. We are Modern Woodmen, a fraternal financial services organization, member owned, not stockholder run. Since 1883, we've supported families, strengthened communities, and helped people reach their financial goals. From protection to saving to retirement planning, let us help you plan for those special moments in your life.
County Marketplace, your hometown grocery store for over 45 years, providing you with quality meat and produce, a full-service deli and bakery, and delivery service or curbside pickup, just to mention a few things. Check out their daily deli specials, including the best fried chicken in the area. Their friendly staff is ready to serve you for all your grocery needs. Located at 412 South Main Street in Pinckneyville, 618-357-2750.
The Indians will control on the alternating possession. You got any numbers out of that first quarter, Gary?
Yeah, the Indians were 3 of 9 from the field. The Panthers 7 of 15. Panthers 0 for 1 from the line, 3 turnovers. The Indians 1 out of 2 from the line, and they turned it over. five times.
With the ball is Johnson. Over to the left it goes now to Jones. Jones will give it back to Johnson on the right side. Jones works down in the corner. Tried to get it to Maynard and almost had it picked. Maynard comes in right of the lane. Kicks it out left side to Jones. Jones with the dribble. Now at the top it goes to Maynard for three. That's good. He's got a pair of threes and it's 16-11 in favor of DuPoint. Maynard has seven to lead the Indians.
In favor of the Panthers, you mean?
In favor of the Panthers, yes. With the ball, Keith now. Keith working in the lane. His shot's up. No good. Tipped around. Rebound comes to, and back the other way goes, beating the Panthers down the floor with Demarion Johnson. And it's 16-13. Hunter Smith into the front court. He'll give it ahead to Keith, and Keith is fouled on the play by Jones. ...16-13, Panthers with the lead. They haven't scored in a little while here. And the inbound play will occur to the left of the goal, the Panther goal. Hunter Smith will trigger the inbound play. Smith gets the ball into Lahr. Wow. Talk about getting mugged. Inbound play by Barsax. Goes to Hunter Smith. That's off the mark. The rebound comes to Lahr. Back to Hunter Smith at the right wing. Over to Barsax at the left. Barsax comes left of the lane. Out goes to Barsax. He comes to glass, lays it up and in. And he's fouled. Nice move by Barsax coming in from the right baseline. 18-13. Barsax with a chance to complete a three-point play.
Call that foul on Barter.
Free throw by Barsax is no good. Rebound of the Indians. 18-13 with the ball is Johnson. Johnson works just left of the circle. He'll give the ball now to Jonathan Brown. Back to Johnson. Johnson comes in right. Now on top, down to the left it goes to Jones. Jones now back to the top to Brown. Back to Jones on the left. Jones. Now back to Brown at the right, just right of the circle. Tried to go inside to Hunter Smith, and it was picked off. Smith, oh, man. What in the world? Back come the Indians. Now with the ball is missing the shot. The rebound comes to Hunter Smith.
Who was that, Brown?
Brown. With the ball now is Hunter Smith, deep left corner of Barsax. Barsax now Smith. Over to the, now inside to Conkle. Up, good. And it's 20-13. With the ball now is Johnson. Johnson works left in the lane. And they call a blocking foul on the Panthers. Man, the it's Barsax's first personal. The inbound play will occur left of the goal. Ball comes into Maynard. Maynard with the ball reverses along the baseline. Puts up a wild shot. The rebound to Keith. Keith into the front court now. He'll give it over to Lahr. Lahr at the top of the circle. Right side to Barsax. Barsax with the ball at the right wing. He'll give it up to Hunter Smith. Now the ball to Lahr. Lahr with the ball. Now back to Smith. Over to the right he goes to Barsax. Barsax now Lahr. Lahr with the ball. He'll give it up to Keith, left side. Inside to Conkle. Now we got a foul on Bardo as he tried to come around Conkle.
That's his second.
Jewel's going to come back in for the Indians and replace Bardo. 20-13, and also back in the game comes Traylon Smith. Inbound play triggered by Keith. Gets the ball into Hunter Smith. Smith on top to Barsax. Barsax for three. That's no good. Rebound off of Lahr out of bounds. with the ball is Traylon Smith as he walks to the timeline. Goes over to the right side to Jonathan Brown. Brown out to the top. It goes to Jones. Now left side to Smith. Now the ball to Maynard. Maynard with the ball over to the right. It goes to Jones. Jones out on top. Smith, left side Maynard. Maynard. Now the ball goes to Jones. Now Brown. Now to Maynard. And almost threw it away. He walked with the ball. No call. Now Jewell with it. Now the ball goes to Smith. Smith with the ball and the dribble across the top. 4:20 left in the first half. 20-13 Panthers. Over to the left it goes to Maynard. Now to Smith. Smith now Jones. Excuse me. Yes, Jones. Jones. Over to Smith at the left. Smith still with the dribble. Smith down the corner to Jones. Jones. Acrobatic shot is no good. Now the rebound to Cockle. The outlet that goes to Keith. Keith racing in. And he's fouled on the play by and Keith will shoot a pair of free throws.
Call that on Smith?
Yes.
His first. AJ to the free throw line. First time tonight. Here's his first one on the way, and it's good.
Panthers.
I think Colton Smith checked in and replaced Conkle.
I believe you're right. Keith to shoot the second of the two free throws. And it's a 22-13 ball game. With the ball now is Johnson. Johnson works into the front court. Still with the ball on the left wing. Now the ball goes to Maynard. Maynard spins out of traffic. Blocked by Lahr out of bounds. And Maynard grabbed at the ball, and the Panthers will get the basketball now. Inbound play comes to Hunter Smith. Across the timeline. Over to the right side. He'll give it up to Lahr. Lahr with the ball now. Hunter Smith. Smith with the ball at the right. Comes in. Lays it up. Lays it in. And the Panthers' biggest lead is 11. Back comes Smith now for Traylon Smith. Gives it to Jewell. Now outside to Maynard. Maynard in traffic. Kicks it low and throws it out of bounds. We thought Jewell was breaking to the inside, and Jewell broke to the outside, and the turnover occurred. 24-13 Panthers. Inbound play comes to Hunter Smith. Into the front court. Moves over to the left with the dribble. Gives it to Conkle. Now to Keith. Through his hands, almost lost it. Gets it in the corner to Hunter Smith. Drives for the layup and scores. The Indians fail to cut off the baseline, and the Panthers up 13 now. 26-13. With the ball is Smith now. Smith with the ball. Over to the right, it goes to Johnson. Johnson now Wilmington. Wilmington now Maynard. Maynard on the left. At the top of the circle with the dribble. He'll give it to Smith. 2:20 left in the first half. Now to Johnson. Johnson. His shot's on its way and no good. Rebound Conkle. Conkle will kick the ball out in the right lane to Colton Smith. Colton Smith in the front court. Dribbles at the right wing. Picks it up. Gives it up to Keith now. Keith goes inside to Conkle. Conkle in traffic. Shot up and in. Timeout. Full timeout. Charges the Indians. We'll be back in 1 minute.
...1901, the First National Bank of Pinckneyville has been serving Perry County and the surrounding area. At the First National Bank of Pinckneyville, they take great pride in giving back to the community by supporting a myriad of groups and events to help make Pinckneyville a better place to work, live, and raise a family. Find them online today at fnb.com. PNFPville.com. First National Bank of Pinckneyville, proud to support the Pinckneyville Panthers. First National Bank of Pinckneyville, member FDIC. 1901, the First National Bank of Pinckney. Grecian Steakhouse, located on South Main Street in Pinckneyville, has become one of Southern Illinois' finest restaurants. You can choose from a full buffet and salad bar, or pick your selection from a full menu. The Grecian also features a complete bar. They can accommodate parties large or small, and be glad to cater any event as well. The Grecian Steakhouse, a proud sponsor of Panther Sports.
All right, back here at Thomas Gymnasium. Apologize for the end of that end of the half there. We had something went wrong there, and everything froze up. So Panthers on top, 31-15, and we'll check our scoring here for the Indians. Eli Maynard with a couple of baskets and a free throw. I have him with 5 points. Traylon Smith with a basket and 2 points. Jeremiah Jones has a basket and 2 points. Dwayne Wilmington with a basket and 2 points. And Demarion Johnson has a basket and 2 points. 2, 4, 6, 8, and 5 is 13. Somebody got a basket there that I missed, Ted? Oh, Maynard's got 3 point baskets. 3, 6, and 1 is 7. Maynard's got 7 points instead of. I'm all messed up here. So Maynard 7. Smith, Jones, Wilmington, and Johnson have 2 points apiece. 2, 4, 6, 8, and 7, 15. For the Panthers, Brady Conway got in early foul trouble. Set a big part of that. Well, he got those two fouls in the first quarter and set out about half the first quarter, all the second quarter. He has 1 basket and 2 points. Hunter Smith with 2 baskets and a 3-point basket. He's got 7 points. Riley Bowersacks has 2 threes and a 2, total of 8 points. A.J. Keith with 2 baskets and 2 free throws, 6 points. Carson Conkle with 4 baskets and 8 points. So it's Bowersacks with 8, Conkle with 8, Keith with 6, Hunter Smith with 7, and Conway with 2. Panthers up 16-8 at the quarter break. Outscored the Indians 15-7 in that second quarter. They lead here 31-15 at the half. Let's take another 2-minute timeout, and we'll be back in 2 minutes.
1901, the First National Bank of Pinckneyville has been serving Perry County and the surrounding area. At the First National Bank of Pinckneyville, they take great pride in giving back to the community by supporting a myriad of groups and events to help make Pinckneyville a better place to work, live, and raise a family. Find them online today at fnbpville.com. The First National Bank of Pinckneyville, proud to support the Pinckneyville Panthers. First National Bank of Pinckneyville, member FDIC. 1901.
half turnovers. The Panthers with four. Panthers are 2 of 4 from the free throw line. The Indians, excuse me, are 1 of 2. Panthers 13 of 27 from the field. That's just under 50%. We've had a little bit of everything here tonight.
We have. How many technicals in that JV game?
There must have been 4 or 5, right?
5 technicals, I believe.
They ejected the DuCoin coach. I'm not sure if that. Well, I think that one player got ejected too, didn't he? Or he got.
Well, I thought he did, but he came back in a little bit later.
It certainly got the crowd fired up. This game seems to be calm compared to the JV game. So,
pretty good crowd though.
Yeah. So the girls. Seedings came out, Ted. The Panthers got seeded 7th in their subsectional.
Is that right?
Panther girls host that regional tournament.
The Panthers host the sectional?
Girls, yeah. The girl, no, the regional, not the sectional.
Okay. And that's about a week away, isn't it?
I think so. It's a week ahead of the boys, isn't it?
Yes.
I think that sectional's at Nashville, or is it Modern Day? No, I don't know.
I read it.
I think the other regional's at Modern Day, and the sectional's at Nashville.
Well, we're ready to start the second half, and the Panthers will control the basketball on the alternating possession. And the Conway's back in the game along with Hunter Smith and Conkle, Barsax, and Keith. The Indians counter with Smith, Wilmington, Maynard, Jewell, and Johnson. Hunter Smith will bring it in the front court. Over the left side it goes to Conway. Conway now back to Hunter Smith, now Conway. Out on top it goes to Keith, right side, in the right corner to Hunter Smith. Missed the three, and a rebound. Now we got a foul on who?
Somebody on the Panthers.
Called it on Riley Byersax. Inbound play comes to Jeremiah Jones. He brings it into the front court. Over to the right side it goes to Maynard. Maynard with the ball, it works out to the top of the circle. He'll give it to Jewell. Now the ball to Johnson. Johnson now back to Jewell. Over to the right, Maynard. The ball. Maynard down in the corner to Wilmington. Wilmington now back to Maynard. Now out high on the right side. Maynard backing down. Now the ball to Wilmington. Wilmington out on top to Smith. Left side to Jewell. Jewell with the dribble. He'll give it up to Smith. Smith looks left. Now dribbles right. Still with the ball, picked up by Keith. Over to the left, it goes down to Johnson. Johnson down the corner to Wilmington. He shots up and good. And it's 31-17. Back comes Conway now. Over to the left side, it goes to Hunter Smith. Back to Conway. Over to the right, Keith. Now Barsax, right wing. Well beyond the arc, he'll put it on the floor. Give it left to Conway. Across the defense, it goes to Hunter Smith. Now Barsax. Barsax at the top. Left side, it goes to Conway. Conway, now Hunter Smith. Now down the right corner to Conway. Goes inside to Conkle. Up, no good. Rebound tipped out of bounds by the Indians. Triggering the inbound play for the Panthers will be Conway. He'll set up left of the goal. Conway gets it into Keith. Keith shots too hard. Rebound controlled by Maynard, and the Indians race into the front court. Maynard will give it up to Wilmington. Wilmington for three, in and out. Rebound, Wilmington with the follow, up and in. He's got four, and the lead is cut to 31-19. Hunter Smith with the ball on the left. Now Conway. Now back to Conway. Conway goes inside to bar Keith, but he's fouled on the play by Jones. They call it on Wilmington. No.
Three on Wilmington.
Yeah, on Wilmington. Keith will shoot a pair of free throws. That coming with 5:44 left here in the third quarter. Panthers have not scored in the period. Keith's free throws up and good. He'll shoot the second of the two-shot foul. Next free throw's good as well. And Keith gives the Panthers a 33-19 lead. Back comes in the corner to Wilmington. Wilmington's up, no good. Rebound to Bowersacks. Bowersacks will give it up to Keith. Keith races it into the front court now. Check up jumper off the glass and good by Keith. And it's 35-19. And now Hunter Smith tried to block the shot of Smith, but he's whistled for a foul.
First foul on Hunter. This is Traylon Smith at the free throw line.
Trading Station has the largest gun selection in Southern Illinois. The Hicks family has been located at 4952 State Route 13 in Pinckneyville for over 63 years. Hicks Trading Station has over 2,000 new and used guns in stock. A wide selection of ammunition is also available. They will buy, sell, or trade. And get this, everything is guaranteed. They're open 7 days a week from 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. Stop by their location west of Pinckneyville or give them a call, 618-357-2583. Go Panthers!
Welcome back to Pinckneyville, where Webster McGuire just took his third time out of the ball game with the Panthers up 39-19 and 4:56 left in the third. Gary, I know you kind of keep up with that, but is DuQuoin in the same regional complex we are?
Yes.
So they're going to have a long trip too, aren't they?
Yes, they are.
Actually, a little longer. With the ball, Smith into the front court. Smith over to the right side to Johnson. Johnson. Over to the left now to Smith. Now to Maynard. Maynard with the ball. Maynard glides through the hoop and misses a shot and a rebound to Conkle. Conkle. Now Lahr, now Smith. Smith in the front court. Now to Bowersacks. Bowersacks now Smith. Smith with the ball. Now Keith. Keith across to Bowersacks. Bowersacks on top to Smith. Left side it goes to Keith for, and Keith drains another. That's his first three, I guess. Back comes Johnson with the ball. Now to the top to Smith. Now to Johnson. Johnson. 42-19 now. Out on top it goes to Jewell. Left side to Traylon Smith. He lost, couldn't handle a pass, and it hit the boundary marker on the north
right
side of the floor.
Yeah, right there by the scorer's bench.
And Jeremiah Jones checks in and replaces Jewell. Hunter Smith with the ball. Smith into the front court. Over to the left it goes to Keith. Keith with the ball now. Smith. Smith now to the right to Bowersacks. Now to Lahr, right of the free throw line. Back out to Bowersacks. Three's no good. Rebound ball is kicked by Johnson. He runs it down on the far end of the floor. Ball goes over to the left to Jones. And Jones hits a three. And it's 42-22. Back comes Hunter Smith. Over to the left, it goes to Keith. Now on the right side to Bowersacks. Bowersacks works out to the top of the circle, gives it to Smith. Now back to Bowersacks at the right. Bowersacks down on the left side, it goes to Keith. Keith across the defense to Bowersacks. Bowersacks on top of Smith. Left side, it goes to Keith. Keith's three is too strong. Rebound loose on the floor, scramble part, jump ball. Possession arrow favors DuCoin. 2:53 left in the third. Johnson triggering the inbound play to Traylon Smith. Smith into the front court. And now over to the further on the right, it goes to Jones. Back to Smith. Back to Jones on the right side. Jones with the dribble. And the ball's kicked by Conkle out of bounds. Triggering the inbound play will be Jones now. Gets the ball into Smith. 2:35 left in the third. With the ball, Johnson. Down the left corner, Wilmington. Goes inside to Maynard. Outside to Johnson. Now Traylon Smith. Missed a shot. Maynard gets a long rebound. And he misses that and the rebound. Now. Down the left corner goes to Maynard. Back out to Smith. Right side to Johnson. Now to Jones. Rebound Maynard. Reverse layup's good. 42-24. Back comes Hunter Smith for the Panthers. Minute 45 left in the game. Down the left corner goes to Bowersacks. Rebound Wilmington on the weak side. Outlet to Jones. Jones. Now the ball to Smith. Now in the corner to Johnson. Johnson now Wilmington. That's up and no good. Rebound to Conkle. He'll kick it back to Keith now. 1:20 left in the third. 42-24 Panthers. With the ball is Bowersacks. Bowersacks on top to Lahr. Left side it goes to Keith. Keith. Now to Hunter Smith. Right side to Lahr. Lahr. Across the defense to Smith. Inside to Conkle. Now and the ball was tipped by the Indians. And it'll go belong to the Panthers. Conkle's going to go out, and Colton Smith's going to come in. Colton Smith gets it into Keith, and they left him all alone. And he scores a bunny there, and it's 44-24. Under a minute to play now. With the ball at the left is Jones. Jones. Down in the corner goes to Maynard now. Maynard. Still with the dribble. He'll give it out to Jones. Jones with a three. And it's 44-27. Down to the final 25 seconds of the third. Colton Smith with the ball. Now Hunter Smith. Over to the right it goes to Keith. Now back to Hunter Smith. Back to Keith. Down to the final 15 seconds of the third. Now to Hunter Smith on the left. He'll give it over to Colton Smith. Back to Hunter Smith. Goes down in the left corner to Keith. Long range three put up by Smith. And that's going to end the third quarter. 44-27 in favor of the Panthers. We'll be back in 1 minute with the final quarter.
Thank you.
Great Heart products are second to none when it comes to seed quality, seed treatment, and seed performance. Farmers continuously brag about the appearance of our seed as it comes out of the bag, the vigor in which it comes out of the ground, and the high yields coming out of their fields year in and year out. I would describe Great Heart products with two words, quality and performance.
Welcome back to Pinckneyville, where we're set for the fourth and final quarter with the Panthers up by a score by 17 at 44-27. Gary, how the numbers looking?
Well,
you've been too busy, haven't you?
Too busy, yeah.
Panthers will go with Colton Smith, Hunter Smith, Lahr, Conkle, and Keith.
The numbers I got, it say Panthers got five timeouts. The Indians with two.
The inbound play comes to Hunter Smith into the front court. He'll give it to Conkle. Conkle now with the dribble gives it to Hunter Smith with the driving layup. A nice assist there to Conkle, and it's 46-27. Down on the right side it goes to Jaden Davis. Ooh. Jones will trigger the inbound play. Free throw line extended on the east end here. Ball comes into Wilmington, right back to Jones. Jones, reverse layup is good. He's got 10 and the lead is 46-29. Colton Smith over to Hunter with the ball at the right wing. Out on top it goes to Conkle. Now they throw it away as they try to get it inside to Lahr. Back comes Jones now with the ball. Jones with the dribble. He directs traffic. And with the ball on the right side is Brown. Now the left side is Jones. Jones now Maynard. Maynard with the ball. Maynard. His shot is... Ooh, they gave him a three. And his foot was inside the arc here. 46-32. Panthers' biggest lead has been 20, now lead by 14, and Jones picks up the foul. And Conway's going to come in and replace Colton Smith. Inbound play comes to Lahr, giving go play to Conway up and in. Nice finish by Conway, but Lahr with a heads-up assist there. Over to the right side, it goes to Brown. Brown with the ball now, Davis. Over to Jones. Jones cuts down on the left side, down in the corner. He'll give it up to Maynard. Maynard down in the corner is Jones. Inside the ball goes to Brown. Up and no good. Brown gets the rebound. And he sticks it in his foul. Foul will be on Lahr. 48-24. 6:14 left in the ball game. Fishes were. Did he get hurt there, Gary?
Yeah, he's shaking his arm there and everything. They were checking with him to see if he was okay.
So Brown to shoot the free throw. 48-34. Brown makes the free throw. And it's 48-35. 13-point edge. 6:10 left in the ball game. Conway. Into the front court. Goes inside to Keith. Keith up and good. Back comes Maynard with a three. That's no good. The rebound to Keith. He'll give it back to Conway. 5:45 left in the game. Conway into the front court now. Over to the right, he'll give it to Keith. Keith with the baseline drive, and he's fouled on the play by Maynard, I believe. Inbound play, Conway to Keith, up and in. That's his third bunny of the night on those inbound plays. 52-35. Back comes Jeremiah Jones, and Jones is fouled by Conway.
Three fouls now on Conway.
The inbound play comes to Jones. Jones over on the right side now, Brown. Brown, now the ball went to out to Jones. Now the ball to Brown. And now Brown threw it cross court to the coach. 52-35 the score. Davis goes out. Comes in the backcourt to Conway. Conway. In the front court on the left. Now with the ball. Now a foul called on Johnson. And the inbound play will be triggered by Conway. Conway looking. 5 second violation.
Well, he missed a wide open Bauer sacks.
Inbound play comes to Jones. Jeremiah Jones over to the right to Brown. Brown on top to Johnson. Back to Jones. Jones at the left wing, down in the corner, and it goes out of bounds off the Indians. A.J. Keith to Conway on the inbound play. Conway into the front court now. Over to the right side, he'll give it to Keith. Keith with the ball at the wing, now to the top. Left side to Barsacks, top of the circle. Now Conway on the left. Conway. He'll give it on top to Conker. Conker. Over to Smith now. Smith with the ball. Smith high on the right side, 4:10 left in the game. Now Keith, now Conway. Conway. Now Conkle at the top. Conkle, now Barsacks, right to Keith. Out on top to Smith. Missed the three and a rebound controlled by the Indians. Coming down on 3:50 left in the game, 52-35. And now, Conway has picked up foul number four, I believe. 30-second timeout, charges to the Indians.
All right, 3:51 left on the clock. It's 52-35 Panthers. The Indians use their fourth timeout. They've got one left. Panthers still have five timeouts. So. We got quite a student section over there tonight.
They do.
Doing a tomahawk chop or something, aren't they? What is that?
That's
what they do down in Atlanta.
.351 is all that's left in this one, and the Panthers are up 17. Turning the inbound play will be Jones gets it into Demarion Johnson. Johnson across the top with the dribble. Johnson now to Wilmington. Wilmington is fouled by Bowersax.
I thought he got away with a walk there.
Inbound play triggered by Maynard. Maynard gets the ball into Johnson. Johnson out on top. The ball goes to Brown. Now back to Johnson. Johnson got into traffic. Kicks it out to Jones. Jones now the free throw line. Now moves out to the right side. 3:25 left in the game. Jones gives it inside to Brown. Brown. Jump ball, possession arrow, DuCoin. Oh, no, with the Panthers, huh?
Yeah, it's Panther ball. That's stuck up there between the rim and the backboard.
That's happened four games on us this year, hasn't it?
Well, a couple, two or three times, I know, yeah.
With the ball on the left side now is Hunter Smith. Smith with the ball on the top to Keith. 3:05 left in the game. Now the ball to Conway on the right. Out to Conkle. Over to the left to Hunter Smith. Now Bowersax. Bowersax now Keith. Keith with the ball. Now Conway. Over to the right it goes to Hunter Smith. Now the ball goes to Conkle. They let time wind away as DuCoin didn't pressure Conkle at all. Now Bowersax with the ball. He'll give it over to Conway. 2:35 left in the ball game. With the ball, Keith, now right side to Smith. Hunter Smith, now to Conkle at the top. Conkle, now Conway left side. Hunter Smith goes inside to Conkle. Conkle up and in. Down the other way comes Johnson, missed a shot and a rebound to Conkle. He'll give it back to Keith. Now to Conway, coming down on 2 minutes left in the ball game. 54-36. With the ball is Bowersax, the left wing. Bowersax. 5 second violation.
You can't just stand there with the ball, can you?
No.
Not when they're guarding you like that. You gotta get rid of it.
Lauren Colton Smith come into the game. Out goes Conkle and Hunter Smith. 1:52 left in it. With the ball is Johnson now. Johnson. Over on the left with the dribble. Now goes in the corner to Brown. Brown with the ball. Now out on top it goes to Jones. Jones with the ball. Jones missed the three and a rebound to Lahr. Lahr back the other way. Lahr. Now Conway. Timeout. And Matt Lahr is going to bring in his whole bench.
Right, so the Panthers use a timeout here. Get some substitutions in the ball game. Minute 24 to go.
With the ball is Colton Smith. Down in the corner, Marshawn Fisher. Fisher with the ball. Looks inside. Now, foul on the play by Maynard.
Maynard bailed him out, didn't he?
Yeah. Triggering the inbound play is Reen Marlowe. Tried to go inside to Lahr, and Wilmington stepped in front of the pass. Now the ball's loose. The Indians recover. With the ball is Johnson out to Maynard for three. That's no good. And Demarion Johnson picked up the foul as he pushed, I believe, Colton Smith from behind. Hello to the Simses tonight down in Harrisburg. We're picking the action up on PCSportsInfo.net on the YouTube.
This is
Reed Marlowe.
Yeah.
Marlowe makes the free throw. 55-35. And Marlowe makes them both. And that's the Panthers' biggest lead at 21. 56-35. With the ball is Jones. Over to the right side, Brown. Brown. Over to Jones. Jones. And he's fouled on the play by Marshawn Fisher. Now Jones will shoot the free throws.
Got the first one down.
So Jones is good on the first. He'll shoot the second of the two-shot foul. Missed that one. A rebound to Teal. And back come the Panthers. Colton Smith has it. Smith at midcourt. Smith over to the left side now. Still with the basketball. Knocked away, but Colton's able to recover it. Now we're down to the final 15 seconds of the ball game. Lars got it at midcourt. Down to the final 10 seconds. And the ball goes in the backcourt, and that's going to do it. Panthers are going to win it 56-35. And Gary, is that number 20?
That's number 20, 56-36.
We'll take a two-minute timeout. We'll be back with our Great Heart Seed Player of the Game.
At Moore Brothers Auto Sales on Illinois Highway 154 in Pinckneyville, they are the small-town dealer with the big-time savings. At Moore Brothers Auto Sales, their customers know they can count on quality used cars, great prices, and a knowledgeable sales staff. Whether you're looking for an automobile, a truck, a van, or an SUV, you can find what you need at Moore Brothers Auto Sales. You can call them or text them anytime at 357-2711. And shop online through their website at morebrothersautosales.com.
Life is made up of moments. We care about those moments as much as you do. We are Modern Woodmen, a fraternal financial services organization, member-owned, not stockholder-run. Since 1883, we've supported families, strengthened communities, and helped people reach their financial goals. From protection to saving to retirement planning, let us help you plan for those special moments in your life.
Time now for our Great Heart Seed Player of the Game. And that goes to A.J. Keith tonight with 19 points in the game. A.J. Keith, he's our Great Heart Seed Player of the Game.
Great Heart products are second to none when it comes to seed quality, seed treatment, and seed performance. Farmers continuously brag about the appearance of our seed as it comes out of the bag, the vigor in which it comes out of the ground, and the high yields coming out of their fields year in and year out. I would describe Great Heart products with two words, quality and performance.
All right, back here at Thomas Gymnasium. Panthers win this one 56-36. And win number 20 for the Panthers. 20-7 now on the season. 5-2 in conference play. DuQuoin drops to 7-16, and they are 1-6 in the conference. Scoring went like this. Jeremiah Jones led the Eli Maynard led the Indians with 12 points. Jeremiah Jones had 11. Traylon Smith with 2. Dwayne Wilmington with 6. Demarion Johnson had 2. And Jonathan Brown had 3 points. For the Panthers, as Ted said, A.J. Keith led the way with 19 points. Carson Conkle with 12. Hunter Smith had 11. Riley Bowersacks with 8. Brady Conway with 4. And Reed Marlowe with 2. Panthers led this one all the way. I don't believe we ever trailed in this game. 16-8 at the quarter break. 31-15 at the half. 44-27 at the end of three, and they win it here 56-36, 20-7 on the season, and 5-2 in the conference. And we say the Panthers just have to keep winning the conference games and hope somebody knocks off the Rangers. And I don't know if that's going to happen, but we can always hope.
That's right. That's right.
And DuQuoin about got him here. When was that? A week or so ago.
But DuQuoin gave him a real good game.
So, stayed right with him and only lost by 10. So, Panthers complete the triple header here. They sweep the Indians. The freshman won 41-26. The JV won 51-31. And the varsity wins 56-36. So, Matt Lahr will be joining us here in just a moment, and we'll get some thoughts and comments on the from the Panther coach. I thought the Panthers played pretty good tonight, all except for the first minute or so of that second half.
I'd have to agree with you. They struggled a little bit to start that second half, like you say, but otherwise played pretty solid game.
Yeah, so looks like maybe Coach keeps talking about want to play your best basketball this time of the year as we head into the postseason, and perhaps the Panthers are doing just that. So Matt Lahr is headed our way, so we'll have our Coach's Corner program coming up right after we take this break. We'll be back in a minute.
Scotland Drug Facebook page. Scotland Drug and Pinckneyville, 90 years, they've been keeping up with the time.
Coach's Corner.
Can you hear?
Scotland Drug. Online at scotlanddrugcompany.com. Visit them in store to pick up your Panther gear. Scotland Drug, serving Pinckneyville and the surrounding communities since 1932. And now, the Coach's Corner.
All right, Matt Lahr is joining us. Hey, Coach, nice win tonight by the Panthers, number 20. Congratulations.
Hey, thank you. Thank you. Feels
20,
good. We got to be brief because I got to get out there and win myself a cake. No, great win tonight. I just told you guys, defense, you know, our effort and energy was fantastic all night. Our defense was great. We did a great job on the rebounds, except for when we played a little bit of that zone. We don't play a ton of that. We just had a funky matchup in for all the guards they had on the floor, so I thought, what the heck, we'll take a look at it. It's definitely something we've used intermittently here throughout the year, but I thought the guys did a great job. Energy, effort, yeah. And we took care of the basketball.
Yeah, I thought you played a real good game all except for about a minute of that start, that second half.
Yeah, we let 41 now. Those may have been shots we don't mind him taking, but they did get loose, get a couple open looks, and we didn't execute very well. We settled too many times for threes when we had it open on the inside. But beggars can't be choosers. It was a heck of a game.
A little short in the guard department tonight. They got some guys in street clothes over there.
Bird's got the concussion, and Leitz went down with a sprained ankle. Hopefully he'll be okay. I think Sam says just a sprain, so he's going to reevaluate it tomorrow. We'll see where he's at. But Colt Smith stepped up and did a great job. We had Conway in foul trouble in the first half too, so we really didn't have him available either. But guys played great.
Now Colton Smith comes in, gives you some good minutes, and as does your son Ty, and that's important when you're playing with a sharp bench.
Yeah, no question, and it's important, you know, not only for this year but for the future of our program too, for those guys to get big, meaningful minutes. Packed house tonight, great crowd, two great student sections, so really good experience for those guys to get, and I'm really glad that we were able to play everybody tonight because, like I said, nobody's more important than the other guy, and any chance I can get everybody in a ball game, that certainly makes me happy as a coach.
Understanding that Duke Point is not quite up on the level of some of the teams, but your defense was really solid, as you pointed out.
Yeah.
And your communication was back in full force tonight.
Yeah, guys did a great job talking, and that's what we say when we communicate, when we talk, and hey, Grady just got himself a cake, attaboy. I don't have to go down there now, guys. You got me as long as you need me. When we communicate and we talk and we listen, we do a heck of a job, and we had a pretty good scout down on them, and we knew their the personnel really well, and the guys actually stuck to the game plan. So it was fantastic effort all the way across the board defensively, and that led to a lot of our offensive successes as well.
Coach, a triple header win here tonight.
Yeah, so. nothing better than a triple header rivalry win. So we made mention of that in the locker room, and we got sophomores playing tomorrow at Sparta, then we got JV varsity up at Freeburg tomorrow afternoon. So another busy day tomorrow.
So Coach Williams told me hope to get that game over and get them sophomores up for that JV.
Get them, especially now we got to get them up there because now we're out two juniors that play JV. So we may have to expedite or expedite the bus ride or hold the game back just a little bit. But I'm sure they'll get over there and have a great game at Sparta, and they'll make it up there in plenty of time.
They're playing Murfreesboro for the championship.
They're playing Murfreesboro for the championship.
My grandson is Josh Colombi. That was put out of that's my grandson.
Okay, we're doing a radio show.
I'm contesting it.
We got an angry fan.
I couldn't hear what was going on.
Well, she's protesting something. She's not happy. That's all right. You can't keep them all happy, guys.
That's Coach, right up here to the end, I only had you with six or seven turnovers.
Yeah, I think I was just looking at that as I was walking up here. I think this has eight, and we gave up seven offensive rebounds. And one of those turnovers came late in the game in a silly situation for them.
That's pretty good looking cake he's carrying back there.
Hey, all right. I like it.
Coach, next week you get a full week of practice.
Yeah.
With the situation, nobody else gets banged up tomorrow, you probably need that full week.
Yeah, absolutely. And we need some rest. You know, we've had what, 3 weeks in a row with three games.
Yeah.
I'm a big believer in you not only need to rest your body, but you need to rest your mind. I mean, it's a grind. The basketball season's a grind, and it's not only physical, it's emotional, and it's mental. So we're definitely going to rest our bodies and minds next week a little bit and be ready to go. But we got to battle tomorrow first. That's obviously a huge game for me and huge game for our program.
Seedings come up next week?
Yeah, seedings come out next week, absolutely. So you guys have seen our subsectional. We've had six teams in and out of the top 20, and several teams in and out of the top 10 all year long. So there's not going to be any games in that whole thing, whether it's a quarterfinal, semifinal, or championship game. That's a loaded deal. But that's what Illinois high school basketball is all about. You got to play the best to be the best.
What's your thoughts on the seedings? Breeze Central one.
I won't go any further than that.
Yeah,
that's the, you know, that one's the no-brainer. That one's for sure. Their resume is speaks for itself, and they're going to be the one, and we'll just kind of have to wait and see how the rest of it unfolds.
Coach Wagner in the past always said this is probably the toughest sectional complex in the state.
I don't see how it isn't. I was in it at Freeburg the last couple of years, so I certainly know. You know, we had several 20-win seasons where we're playing a play-in game, and a couple years it was against Althoff, and then we end up meeting Pinckneyville one year. We've lost to Althoff a couple times, up there. So it's brutal. And that's another team that kind of goes unmentioned. You got all the teams with the 20 wins and this and that. Altoff's a heck of a ball club, and they're probably right around 500, and they're really good.
Coach, yeah. What can we expect from Freeburg? They got the one kid, I can't think of his name.
Yeah, Cole
He's
Stewart.
Averaging almost 20 points
yeah.
a game.
So. Electric player, was a great player for us, and a kid that I really enjoyed coaching. He scores 20 a game. They got another senior that can just shoot the lights out of it. And then their third senior is a kid that kind of does a little bit of everything. He can post up. He can shoot the three. So they're going to get after it. You know, that's going to be a big game for them, obviously, like it is for me and for our team. But they're a good ball club. They've won, I think. I know they're at Salem tonight. I haven't seen that score. I think they've won five or six in a row. They beat Murphy to win the championship up at Sparta a week or so ago, and they knocked off Oakville the other night, and they're at Salem tonight. So they're a good ball club. We'll be ready to go. Quick turnaround.
Yeah. I think Coach Opp was telling me they got one player that shot 180 yeah, shots or something.
That's Caleb Johnson, number 33.
He's 150 over threes.
He's a heck of a shooter. Yep, yep.
Coach, I know they don't consider this, but strength of schedule, the Panthers have probably played as strong a schedule as most of the player teams in that complex.
Yes, yeah, absolutely. We have. Now, Modern Day's played a really strong schedule, and Nashville's played a really strong schedule. And, you know, to be honest with you, several teams have, but ours, kind of looking at some of the numbers that the folks have ran, we're right up there near the top with strength of schedule, for sure.
Yeah. Of the games you've lost, is there a game you'd like to have back?
Yeah, all of them. you know, every one of them. Heck, what did we say, 20 and 7?
Yes.
Yeah, I'd like to be 27-0. You know, every loss is uniquely different, and, you know, as a coach and a competitor, you don't want any of them. You want to have all of them back. But I do think after each and every one of them, we've learned and we've gotten better, and, you know, that's what athletics and sports is all about. Learn from your mistakes, get better, and be a better version of you tomorrow than you were today. And, you know, if we're doing that, we're all successful.
Hey. Thanks for stopping by.
Absolutely.
I want to see you go down there and run a game.
Hey, I shot with the guys today after school for a while. I got the jump shot back. So I dunked one too, believe it or not.
Oh,
so
no.
Every now and then I'll dunk one. And I'll mark the date because you never know when it's going to be my last. Because that last one, fellas, is coming sooner rather than later. So hey, you guys have a good night. We'll see you tomorrow afternoon.
See you tomorrow afternoon.
All right, thanks, Coach. That's been head coach Matt Lahr, Panthers 56, the Indians 36. Panthers are 20-7 on the season and 5-2 in the conference. So Freeburg tomorrow afternoon. We'll pregame that one about 1:45. So we hope to see you there. So let's thank Matt, who's engineered this game for us again out there on Broadcast Hill. For Matt Lahr, for Ted Cunningham, I'm Gary Pratt saying good night from Thomas Jim.
Good, Christy.